that's quite a long. That's quite a long.
It's one big rush.
That's quite a long.
That's right.
Yes, we look great there. See, I have my shoes on. Yes. That's quite long.
He's doing his thing. It's the only time he can get
it. Exactly.
When he gets bigger, he can't have it.
Don't think so?
My daughter's.
You know what? We don't have it.
That's right.
I just worry about it. You know?
When I said to her, unless she didn't make you wear one of those, and she says, oh no! Hey, I used to say to my mother, I'm not a frills girl.
No. Harper is not a frills girl.
Harper is not a frills girl.
She is my frilly girl.
I don't blame her. I don't know. Me either.
Good morning, Harper.
I should have said to you on stage. That's okay. I'm not supposed to be me.
Yeah.
I like it.
You
all right? I like it. It's perfect.
Okay.
All right. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Let's turn to number 601 in the hymnal. Thy Word. We'll start out with Thy Word.
Do you have a hymnal down there?
I have one.
Because, as we always say, two or three of us are gathered in your name, and there's plenty of us gathered in your name, so help us know you're with us. Let us hear your word. Let us take it in. Let us use it to make us grow closer to you. We ask you to be with us throughout this service, in our songs, in our words, in our prayers, and in our fellowship. We praise you and thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's go to another prayer, which is a song, Sanctuary. It's number 2164 in the Faith We Sing, Sanctuary.
Welcome. So nice to see so many smiling faces. And though I don't see you online, I know you're smiling. We had our chicken and biscuit this past week, and another very successful dinner, and thank you to all. Whether you're there working or home praying or just enjoying the meals that we prepare, thank you. We appreciate everything. We have our conference coming up in sometime...
November.
Prior to that, chair people will have to get together. We have quite a few forms that we need to fill out, as well as members who are on those committees. There are forms for each committee, but I think it would be easiest if we just pick a day, try to get together, and go through them. I printed half of them, then I ran out of ink. But story of the life here right now, too. So I'll be speaking with a lot of you to see when we can get a date that we can all get together and fill out these forms. They want them submitted prior to our meeting. Then when we do have our meeting, everyone is invited to the meeting. And we'd love to have as many people show as we can. So Steve is trying to figure out a date and time that will work so most of you will be able to attend.
I'm trying for November 13th at 6 p.m. at this point.
6 I won't
p.m.
Be here.
So that's those that work.
You're gonna be out west?
No, I'm gonna be in Bermuda.
Oh, Sue's gonna be cruising. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh. Well, you can Zoom in.
No.
Yeah, no, she's not gonna do that. We'll meet prior to that so that you're aware, because a large portion of it is the finance committee. So that's why we'll do that ahead of time. I also, before I see if anybody else has anything, it's time to think about the tea, interface tea. This year it's being hosted by the Johnstown Reformed Church and I don't know how to say that, Kenneth Israel Synagogue. And it goes through to say that, again, it's the tea. It is going to be held on Tuesday, October 15th at the Johnstown Reformed Church. They're having a planning meeting Tuesday, the 10th, so this week, at the Reformed Church. If anyone is interested in going and representing our church in the setting up of it, that'd be great. If not, we haven't had anybody do that in a while because of just lack of people. But you still, even though we don't help with the planning, it's still a nice event. Betty Lou's gone many times, and she
really nice.
Yeah, she really likes it. We will be sending them a contribution to help offset the cost. It's $10. So that is coming up. I will post this in the back. So if anyone is interested, I'd say take a picture with your phone because we don't have a copy of it right now. Also, we received a lovely thank you from Ann Orr's daughter, Kathy. And it said, to the Wells Methodist Church and Ladies of the Kitchen, thank you all for making us all feel so loved and welcome to your church. This church meant so much to my mom, and she had missed it greatly. Thank you to all the women who cleaned, made drinks, and made sure it was perfect for my mom's celebration of her life. You all did so much, and it was all greatly appreciated. It was such a blessing that we didn't have to take out of our family time to clean up. You all did that. It was so wonderful and amazing. Many blessings, Kathy Eldridge. This will also be hung in the back. Do we have any other announcements? Anything coming up that I don't know? No? How about birthdays and anniversaries? I skipped over those.
My little friend Hector's birthday, from the little guy that I met, those of you who know, down at Popeye's, he turned 10 last Wednesday.
Nice. So. Happy birthday, Hector.
You should have brought him in so we could sing to him.
Yeah, what he was going to do is, his mother, they were planning on coming up to see us and spend a week up here, and he wanted to come to church. The company she worked for mysteriously automatically just shut down. She's got a new job, and she will not be able to make it up here until next year. So, but they, you will meet him. He will be here at one time or another.
Any other birthdays or anniversaries? And welcome. Thank you for joining us this Sunday. It's nice to see you on sometime other than Wednesday. Yes, I am. I wasn't sure if you read lips.
Yes, for those of you that are here, notice that Will has joined us. Will does not hear, so, but he reads lips pretty well, if you're close to him. So please,
get a little closer.
Don't think he's ignoring you.
No,
because Will's a very nice guy, and we're welcoming here, so welcome.
I'll learn.
And so will we. All right, let's move on then to our call to worship. And you'll find that in your bulletin. The congregation reads the bold, and I'll read the leader part. Welcome, beloved. Why have you gathered today?
We have come to worship God, who is the maker of us all.
What do you seek from God, our Creator?
We seek God's wisdom to guide us and show us how to live.
Are you ready to follow when God's wisdom leads down unexpected paths?
We will trust and we will follow wherever God's wisdom leads us.
Well then, beloved of God, what are you waiting for?
Come, let us worship and seek God's uncommon wisdom together. Amen.
You'll find our opening prayer also in your bulletin. Feel free to follow along or to join me. Heavenly Father, we pray that Jesus might be seen in all of us, and that in the power of the Holy Spirit, all we say and do will be done to your honor and glory. Thank you that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Thank you also for your word, which teaches us how to live godly in Christ Jesus, and for this important lesson, which calls us for humility of heart and a genuine love and respect for all our brothers and sisters in Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Our next hymn is Living for Jesus, and you'll find that on page 2149 in the Faith We Sing. That's the little black book.
He's got a good voice. You can come out and sing with me.
Yeah, I had it anyway.
I don't have it in the right key yet, so
it's small. It was a good thing.
It's David's his key.
I'm higher.
That's the key right there.
I'm off key.
Thank you.
But teach you about it.
Or play the drum, whichever.
Well, and
all right, Steve, who has some praises out there to share this morning?
Especially Steve, can I say, and if you're questioning how God feels about dancing, in Psalm 149, it says, "Let Israel rejoice in their Maker. Let the people of Zion be glad in their King. Let them praise his name with dancing and make music to him with tambourine and harp."
Oh, that's what we need. He's the Lord of the dance.
Yes.
I'll tell you, she doesn't need any exercise later.
All right, who has some praises? It's a praise to see these young ones here. Praise to have Will here this morning. Praise to have you all here, by the way.
I had a family picnic yesterday, and I've got to congratulate the weathermen for the first time in years. They were right on. It poured rain.
Yes.
And four very brave souls showed up for my picnic. All women, so we had a ball.
Nice. I'm sorry.
Here's a praise.
It's probably me praying that my dog fertilizer is working in it.
Oh, Jesus.
And it rained all day. Yeah, we were set. Yep. It looks much better with grass.
He wants those, these cough drops. Yeah. Probably not a good idea.
No. I also want to say thank you to our church for the card that my very dear friend and sister, Pat Kennedy, received last week for the death of her husband. I was very proud to be a part of this church. So thank you very much. I'm blessed, and we're blessed.
We're proud. We're all proud to be part of this church, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, he's all done talking now, right?
Well,
all right, who's got another praise?
Next year's drummer.
Yeah, yeah.
Elsie's got one.
I had a nice visit with Roy Hassel, and he's getting chemo tomorrow, Tuesday.
Okay.
And he really didn't look too good. So let's pray a lot for him.
Yeah. Sometimes they don't.
Right?
He came to our chicken and biscuit dinner this week. He was writing a check out, and I told him to add another zero at the end of there, but I don't know if he did it.
JR actually received news yesterday that he is officially an LLC and has his own small business now. And he will be, we're just waiting on the FFL for him, but he's looking to open an ammo shop.
Oh. Well, good for him.
Yeah.
That's
good.
Great. Wonderful. Congratulations. So, it can be a blessing and a curse to run your own business. I've been there and done that.
It's not like we don't have anything to do. So.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
It'll be fun.
One more thing. So they say.
Yeah. Anyone else?
Steve, it's a blessing that so many people are working so hard for this church. There's a lot of things that go on behind the scenes that nobody sees, but there are so many people really giving so much to help us to grow and to be a positive part of our community.
Amen. So now I'm going to ask you, in my message today, I'm going to ask you to work even harder. So.
Thank you.
But that's what God wants us to do, just keeping on. He doesn't quit when it's not one and done. You just keep doing for God. So that's why I don't need to give my message now, I just did. Any other praises?
Actually, last week we prayed for Hunter Rose. He's the young man. He was going through a really hard patch right then, and they didn't think he was going to make it. He's gotten over that hump, and when his parents talked to the doctors, they said, "We don't know what brought him through this." Well, we know what brought him through this, and so does his family. So he's still very ill, but that he got over that hump. So keep praying for Hunter, because God's laying his healing hands on him.
Amen, amen. Well, that is a praise indeed. How about some other concerns? That's a praise and a concern there. So, other concerns out there that you want to share this morning?
We need to pray for me.
Yes.
Yes, we do.
One last week to have biopsies done. They found what they suspect is more cancer. And in the process of doing the biopsies, I won't go into great detail, but the doctor accidentally hit a nerve with a needle. If he had severed the nerve, it would have lost total use of my left leg. There's no fixing that. If you see me kind of wandering around today with a limp, they are hoping, they're very good hoping that it will come back fully, but it's going to take some time. Guy said to me the other day, he says, "You're very lucky." I said, "No, I'm not lucky at all. God was watching out for what happened, and he prevented a disaster is what happened." That's how I feel anyway. But continue the prayers for me, if you would, please, because this is about the most painful thing I've been through in a very long time. And I don't care to ever go through it again. But doctors are hopeful it'll come back, and so am I. I pray every day to the Lord that if I can't hunt or take care of Trevor, I don't have a life. Hunt, fish, and Trevor, and camp, and that's what we do. So, and I'll keep going. They want me off my feet, but imagine that. You know, with Trevor, can you imagine being off your feet for a week or so?
A week, 5 minutes.
Yeah. You want to give us an update on the young man or the fellow you were praying for last week?
Chuck.
Chuck, yeah.
Yes, I'm sorry. My father-in-law had a massive heart attack the other day. And Chuck has an extensive background history like I do of a lot of things wrong. They got him in Ellis Hospital, and after a 2-hour and 45-minute ambulance ride that nobody knows where they went and they're not saying, from Gloversville to Ellis Hospital, they finally got him there. He's not a candidate for surgery because his lungs are so weak that he would never last the surgery. So they did a cardiac cath on him, and they found out he had 2 plugged stents. So the surgeon decided that open heart surgery wasn't in reality at that point in time. So what happened was, him and another surgeon got together during the cardiac cath, and they were able to, during the cath, change those 2 stents out without putting him through open heart surgery because he wouldn't live. So he's home. He came home yesterday afternoon about 6 o'clock. So he went from, they didn't think he was going to make it, to being back home again. So that in itself is a praise, a very good praise, but we got to keep him in our prayers because he's not out of the woods yet. And he's like I am, you can't sit out. You gotta keep going. So he takes care of 2 of his grandchildren that live with him. And he's a very busy man. He's very big in the Baptist Church in Johnstown on Route 30 down there going into Fonda. He's a deacon there. And keep praying for him if you would, please. The prayers that we got the other day, I believe, worked. So does he. I told him we were praying for him, and he was very happy and excited for that.
Amen. Thank you, Gary.
You're welcome.
Any others? Lots of things to pray for. I continue to pray for the William and the William Bill that I mentioned last week. One is in Florida and one is elsewhere. So they're on our prayer list. So we have people watching that will know about this. So pray.
It would be a second cousin in the Summerfield family. He was 40 years old, he was a twin, and he passed away a week ago Friday, so.
I'm sorry. So we pray for that family. Mm-hmm.
And for Sean O'Rourke, who is still recovering in Albany Med, and...
Oh, he's in Sunnyview.
Oh, he's in Sunnyview now?
Yeah.
Oh, good, I hadn't
heard. He's doing better.
He's doing better.
Well, they have the benefit for him next Sunday.
Yes. Mm-hmm. The lady next door that gets all the food, she's related to him.
Oh.
Yes, Barbara. Mm-hmm. So I get the latest up.
Oh, that's good. Keep me informed. I only live down the
road. Any others? course, our prayer for our world and our country. So, but let's go to the Lord in general, we'll pray. Precious Heavenly Father, we do praise you and thank you for all the good things you do for us. We just listed a number of praises, that's wonderful. And we also listed some concerns, and we thank you for being with us all in our concerns. We know that you know what they are before we even ask, but we ask just to remind ourselves that you're there and that you answer our prayers for the good of those who love you. We love you, Lord. So, Lord, we're waiting to see the answers to our prayers in your time and for the good of all. So we thank you for that. We pray for all those that we've listed. Now we pray from the depths of our heart for this world and this country. There's so much unrest. We pray that you would somehow cause an end to this fighting, this evil, all of the hate that's in this world. We know that it's been here forever, but Lord, we don't understand what it's all about. You tell us to love each other, to love our neighbors. We can't understand how so many do not hear your word. So Lord, let us know how we can help promote your word. How will we make others know that they need to listen to your word and follow it? Lord, we pray for those countries in war. We pray for our own country, we pray for our cities, we pray for our towns, we pray for our Wells town here, and we pray for all those in it, and our neighbors, and all those in our churches. We also pray for our churches, we pray for our schools that have started up now. Already we hear of a school shooting, Lord. We ask that stop, but we don't have any control. We leave it to you to make that change in this world. Lord, we pray for those in our family that are closest to us and our friends and neighbors. We pray for those that are shut in, those that are sick, those that are stricken with disease, like cancer, or so many others. We pray for those that are afraid to come out of their houses. Finally, we pray for those silent concerns here in this sanctuary, for our own self. Those are those concerns that we're not willing to share because they're too personal. Oh, Lord, we know that you know what they are. And we know that you're working on them. And thank you for being with us through it all. We come to you now with that prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth
as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now is our chance to give back, so the ushers can come forward, please. would we, thank you. Thank you for these gifts. You've given it all to us, now we've given a portion back. So we ask you for your leadership. Teach us how to use these effectively for your ministry, whether it be in this church, in this community of Wells, or in your world, or wherever they're needed most. Direct our attention to what we can do to make that happen. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. All right, Marty's got something to share.
Now, we've done this before, except that I really didn't get up and say too much about it. I want you to look at the refrain. Now, do you have any idea what the refrain is? That's the chorus part. And that's usually the best part of the song. You get to know that first.
So
it says,
number 45, is that right?
I'm not going to even tell them where it is yet.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Surprise.
I need no other argument. I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died and that he died for me. And I'd love to have you put this all into your heart, because things like this come back to me in the middle of a week and I think to myself, oh, come on, please, enough, enough, enough. I got it. I got it. And I know he's on me. So would you look in your white book 45? We weren't quite sure it was in there. We knew it went somewhere, didn't we, Steve? We weren't quite sure it went in there, but it did. But the four verses tell the story. And then you get to do the best part, the chorus, the refrain. Even if you learned a new word today. I can see some still going. I'm not, don't worry.
What's the number?
45.
I'm only at 27, Marty.
Oh, hey, see, some of them didn't quite make it to 45.
You're good.
You got it? Oh, you got it. Okay, okay. Here we go. My faith is from the resting place that it defies the store free. For a while, all the pipes go. But I hate to tell you, my mother came back, and around in her 90s, she became a soprano again. She said to me, maybe you'll be a soprano. I said, I don't think so. I've never been a soprano. So that didn't come over big. How about number two? Here we go.
Enough for me that Jesus saved this sin.
We've lost the power.
What happened?
Well, we have an unplugger.
Okay.
It's Buddy.
He just
turned
it back in. Yeah, but you gotta turn it back on.
Yes, I think we have turned it back on.
Here.
Get that part, we got it.
Difficulties.
There it goes, I hear it.
You should be okay.
Yeah, we're on.
Okay.
It takes a minute because it always looks at me like, yeah, right.
We just persevere, that's all.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Come on. There it is. We're there.
All right.
How about number two?
I need no other.
because that was her favorite and mine too. And it comes back to you and kind of helps you. And he's after you. Yes, he is. And all of us. He died for all of us. Thank you.
Now turn to 2176 and pay consent. Listen one time through. Make me a surrogate.
Today's not summer. We wish.
It's Sunday.
It's Sunday. I need you. Come here.
Come here.
Come here. Come here. I need you. There's something else about today. Anybody know?
That's your birthday.
That's it. It is not my birthday.
It's baby day.
It is not baby day. And I'm not undressing. Oh, wait a minute. Come here. Come here. We got to show them what you got on your shirt. Oh, what does it say? Whoops.
Is it National Grandma Day?
It is National Grandparents Day.
Yeah.
What's it say on his shirt? Always looking up to Grandma. And my shirt, I'm not undressing. What's mine say? What's it got? I don't have a crown today, but I wish I had one. All right, so I'm going to read you this little book. So my grandson's two. You guys will get what's going on here, but he's like, this is my book. It says Grandma and Me. We'll see if he does.
No, he hasn't even seen the middle,
look at,
I don't think.
Look at.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, yeah, yeah, it's going to be wrong.
Wait a minute, let me see if I can get down here. Yeah, look at. Grandma and Me. This is me, and this is Grandma.
She got him.
Yeah, that's exactly what he does. He's trying to figure out.
Can I get that out of there?
We like to soar through the starry skies. Yep. You don't know what that is, do you? We like to count the fireflies. We like to sing hoo hoo hoo. We like to wait with friends too. He's like, I can't figure it out. But what we like the very best is snuggling in our soft, warm nest. I love Grandma, and Grandma loves me. And Grandpa, too, right?
Yeah.
He does the same thing. He was trying to figure out who it was. Okay, now we can get up. So today is Grandparents Day. Oh, my goodness.
I was just saying, now we can get up.
Yeah, I know. I might need some help there.
She's going to get up. She got up.
And I have a bracelet that I wear just pretty much every day. I think we've talked about it. And it says Grandma. I know. See, he does that. He tries to get the finger out of there. He doesn't get it. And then my other one that I always wear with it. Where's my things? Oh, my goodness. I must have lost them. It says, it should say hope, love. I don't know where it went. I must have lost it. I'll have to find it. But let me read you the scripture for today. Okay? Because we have to be good to our grandparents and our parents all the time, right? Okay, give me that. There we go. We're done with that. Ready? It's from Leviticus 19:32. Rise in the presence of the aged. That means kind of like
older people, more wise people, we'll put it that way, show respect for the elderly, those are also older, and revere your God. I am the Lord. Okay, so that's what we gotta do. We gotta tell Grandma and Grandpa thank you today, okay?
Thank you, Mama. Thank you, Mama.
Okay. So we're gonna do a prayer, ready? Come here, come up here. So we can do it.
Give her a hug.
Ready? Thank you, God, for grandparents and parents. There we go. All right. You girls want to go out back?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll go out back for a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Want to pray for this grandma?
Go out back. Yeah.
Dear Lord, thank you for Steve and for all the other grandparents and parents and everyone in this world, and please be with us as we go through this week, and please have Steve share your word with us. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. So my youngest grandson will be born in a couple weeks here. So.
Ah.
Yeah.
All right. So
are you going with them?
It sure did look like it.
Where did it
come from? I dropped my liquid.
Welcome to church, everybody.
When I dropped my liquid, I got away.
Yeah.
So how y'all doing this morning?
Good.
Are you content with life the way it's going for you? No matter, or do you want more? Remember what I said I was going to ask you to do more? No matter what age we are, I think there's still something more that God has put on us on this earth to do. What is Christ calling us to do? You're probably all sitting there thinking, what more can I do, right? I've been doing a lot for Jesus, and what does Jesus want me to do now, plus what I'm doing? You're right to say that we do a lot for this church. I'm proud to be part of this little White Mountain Church right here on the corner of
Buttermilk
Hill. Yeah. Right here where we are, I'm proud to be part of this, and we love you all. And I'm happy and pleased with what you're doing and how you do it. But yes, there's more that we could do. Let me explain. Jesus gave. He gave comfort. He gave healing. He gave compassion. He gave all, including his life, for our salvation. We haven't given all yet, have we? We're still alive, so we didn't give our lives. It's very true that many of us have given a great deal, but we're still alive and breathing, and we haven't given all. I know after one of our chicken and biscuit dinners, we feel like we've given it all, right? And it doesn't hurt to take a day or two to recover from that one. But what about the next days? Do we sit back and just cheer others on? Is chicken and biscuits once a month all that God expects us to do? I don't want to just zero in on the dinner and all those working on dinner, because there's lots of us here that do more than just the dinner. They help us in other things behind the scenes, and fixing things like the trustees do, and planning things like many of you do, and pray. That's important too. So there's all sorts of things that we do. But the point that I'm getting at here is that if we're a true believer in God and His Son Jesus, we will always find there are things that we can do for the church and for others. It is that faith and belief in God and the teachings of God and His Son Jesus that inspires and reflects us inspires us to reflect His image. So you may ask, what is the image of Jesus? Well, I just mentioned it a bit ago. Jesus gave, He gave His comfort, He gave His healing, He gave His compassion. He gave all, including His life, for our salvation. Well, we can't promise salvation. That alone is what Jesus can do. We can't earn it either. Our faith and our belief in Jesus gives us the power to do a great deal. We need to put that faith into action
And do as John Wesley said, and I mentioned this last week if you were here, you recall, do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, in all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as you ever can. Take note of that last statement, as long as you ever can. That doesn't mean one and done. That doesn't mean one good deed and then you're done. Although one good deed is good, better than no good deeds, but it doesn't mean one and done. We are to do all the good we can as long as we can. The good that we do is our works, and they are sparked by our faith. Faith in Jesus and faith in his Father God, they're one and the same, really. But if we have strong faith, we will have what we need to keep going to do the work that Jesus left us here on this earth to do. Today we're talking about faith in deeds, which is the same as saying faith in works. Let's turn in our Bibles to page 1881 and follow along as I share what God has to say about favoritism and works. God inspired Jesus' brother James to write this book of James. Starting in chapter 2, verse 1, and continuing through verse 17, I'll share the following. Favoritism is forbidden. My brothers and sisters, believers in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ, must not show favoritism. Suppose a man comes into your meeting wearing a gold ring and fine clothes, and a poor man is in filthy old clothes also comes in. If you show special attention to the man wearing fine clothes and say, here's a good seat for you, but say to the poor man, you stand there or sit on the floor by my feet, have you not discriminated against among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? Listen, my dear brothers and sisters, has not God chosen those who are poor in the eyes of the world to be rich in faith and to inherit the kingdom he promised those who love him? But you have dishonored the poor. Is it not the rich who are exploiting you? Are they not the ones who are dragging you into court? Are they not the ones who are blaspheming the noble name of him to whom you belong? If you really keep the royal law found in Scripture, love your neighbor as yourself, you are doing right. But if you show favoritism, you sin and are convicted by the law as lawbreakers. For whoever keeps the whole law and yet stumbles on just one point is guilty of breaking it all. For he who said, you shall not commit adultery, also said, you shall not murder. If you do not commit adultery, but you do commit murder, you have become a lawbreaker. Speak and act as those who are going to be judged by the law that gives freedom. By the law that gives freedom. Because judgment without mercy will be shown to anyone who has not been merciful. Mercy triumphs over judgment. Remember that. Mercy triumphs over judgment. Now it goes on to talk about faith and deeds. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if someone claims to have faith but has no deeds? Can such faith save them? Suppose a brother or sister is without clothes and daily food. If one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm and well fed, but does nothing about their physical needs, what good is it? In the same way, faith by itself, if not accompanied by action, is dead. Well, I could talk about the verses, these verses here in chapter 2 for a long time, but I won't. Besides which, we're going to run long as it is. So anyway, James, the disciple who put God's words down in this book, was known as the most pious of all the disciples. I talked about that a little last week too. Most pious. He wasn't one of the original 12 disciples. He came after. But he gives us a lot to think about here. Really, when we look at the basics of what is said here, it's all about having compassion, being non-judgmental, and being like Jesus. It's about helping others when we can. Let's talk about favoritism a little, since it's mentioned. It does go along with being kind and helping others like Jesus did. It's all about loving your neighbor. Remember, you heard that? Love God and love your neighbor. We have to truly show compassion and love to our neighbors in order to be like Jesus. In reading this scripture earlier in the week, I thought back to my growing up days. My parents were not wealthy. I was not brought up in a well-to-do family. Many of you may be able to relate to a sort of similar experience. We had a garden and did a lot of hunting and fishing to put food on the table. I remember many times collecting cans and bottles to turn into the store for a meager refund of a few dollars because we needed it. The result was that I learned to appreciate a lot of little things in life. That included other people who didn't have much at all. I'm thankful for what that style of living taught me. As a result of that, I grew up very shy, however, and without many close friends. The reason for that is I didn't want my classmates to come to our house because we didn't have all the fancy things that many others had. I now know we had something many of the other homes didn't have. We had a close family relationship and a lot of love. I know that that is the best home you could ever have, regardless of the fanciness and possessions. I know that God doesn't show favoritism to those with especially good looks or possessions or social status. He doesn't care what kind of home you live in, what kind of car you drive, or anything like that. God sees our hearts, and that is what is important. What's in your heart? How do you really believe? We have no grounds to judge anyone. God will do that. We need to get to know people for what they really are. If someone has Jesus in their heart, it will show by the things they do and by the way they live their life, not by how beautiful they are or how much stuff they have. Beauty is found in the heart. It's who's living in your heart that counts. It is also who's living in your heart that will inspire you to do the things like Jesus did. In one of the commentaries this week in our disciplines, the author talked about his acceptance and support of all types of people in the church. Will he accept and support all types of people here? Two, no matter what they are, where they come from, what they've done, what color of skin, no matter what they are, they're welcome here. They're not welcome to change everything here, but they're welcome here. We also love them as children of God. We recognize all as sinners in need of grace of God, just like us, because we're all sinners. That's what we all are, because of that initial disobedience of God that Adam and Eve did in the garden. God loved Adam and Eve, but he did not like what they did when they disobeyed. The result was the first man and woman were exiled from the garden. And here we are. We are all called to repentance because of our sin against God and his commands. Well, thanks be to God that he sent his son Jesus to give us a way to get back into his marvelous grace. We are to believe in Jesus, love him, and do our best to reflect his image. We are not to model our actions and our beliefs about others. We are to model it after Jesus. Others are just like us, sinners. So we don't lift them up and model our lives after them. It's Jesus that we model. Jesus loved, so that is what we're supposed to do. We see in our Bible, Jesus did not like what many did, even though he loved them. That included the Pharisees, those buying and selling goods in the temple. Remember what happened there? He whipped and drove them out. And even those who tortured him and put him on the cross. Remember, he said, forgive them before they know not what they do. And he said to the one thief who said he believed he was the Son of God, he said, you will be with me in paradise. Remember that? That's our model. He didn't like people torturing him, I'm sure. but he loved them as children of God. As I said before, Jesus is our model, and we are to reflect his image. We are to honor and promote his lifestyle and his image, because we love what he did for us. We are not to promote and model the image of anyone other than Jesus. We are not called to reflect our own image or that of any other sinner like us. We are all also called to love our neighbor, and our faith and love for Jesus makes us want to do good things for our neighbors. I want to share another short scripture with you that goes along with what Jesus' compassion here. It's an example that calls us to help others. I invite you to turn to 1565 in your pew Bible and follow along as I share God's word from Mark 7, 31 through 37. Jesus heals a deaf and mute man. Then Jesus left the vicinity of Tyre and went through Sidon, down to the Sea of Galilee and into the region of Decapolis. There, some people brought to him a man who was deaf and could hardly talk, and they begged Jesus to place his hand on him. After he took him aside, away from the crowd, Jesus put fingers into the man's ears.
Later?
See you later. And he spit and touched the man's tongue. Marty, as you probably know, goes and plays up north, too. He looked up to heaven and with a deep sigh said to him, "Ephphatha," which means be opened. At this, the man's ears were opened, his tongue was loosened, and he began to speak plainly. Jesus commanded them not to tell anyone, but the more he did so, the more they kept talking about it. People were overwhelmed with amazement. "He has done everything well," they said. "He even makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." As I read this testimony, the author of the Discipline's Devotion wrote for Saturday morning, yesterday morning this was in the book, along with this accompanying scripture, I recalled various times that I've been called to step into the water with Christ and wade out a little bit deeper. The first time was actually when my wife and I felt called to attend church, and that was way back when late 80s or early 90s when my youngest son, Brian, was the only child in the house the whole time. And after that, my daughter was assumed, but that's when I first started attending church. But I felt a strong call for God. After that, it was a pastor who said to me, "You need to go to the Walk to Emmaus retreat." I didn't have a clue what it was, but I trusted him, so I went, but I wasn't really thrilled about it in the beginning. Then it was a call for me to play my guitar in church, because when I went to that mass retreat, I picked up my guitar again after 25 years of not playing, because I was inspired by the music on that retreat. Then it was a call to play my guitar in church, and followed by a member of the congregation telling me that I needed to stand up front in the church and lead singing. That was Howie's mother, actually. Funny how things work. And there I've been standing up in front of the church leading music ever since. After that, I felt the call to be involved in the music ministry and serve on many mass teams. It only continued from there to draw me deeper into the water with Christ. I was continually called to serve on mass teams and eventually be the director for a mass team and for two Christmas teams. That's the retreat for youth. So I was actually called to be direct two of those weekends and one a mass. So soon the call was to join my pastor and Marty to share our talents and whatever we had with this church down here. So we came down here with Dan Burgess and started down here. Then it was the call to be pulpit supply. And the story continues. I wonder what's next for me in the future. Yes, I know there is more. There will be more until the day I leave this earth. Life for me has been an adventure filled with many surprises and challenges. Along with the challenges came some doubt and fear. I'm not lying to you. It's a little fearful to get up here, especially in the beginning. There were times I thought I might be in too deep water to survive, but Jesus was there with his hand down, picking me out, saying, "Hey, don't fear, I'm with you. Fear not." He was with me then, and he is with me now, and he continues to guide my steps and my words. He puts people in my life to aid and guide me when I need support, and that's all of you. You all aid me in one way or another. Without him, I would be nothing. Without him, I'd surely fail. He's always been with me. I just needed to closely listen when he calls and not let his words of truth be drowned out by this world's chaos. And there's plenty of it. I want you to know he will be with you too if you trust him when he calls you to step into the water and wade out a little bit deeper. Do you hear him calling? Will you trust and obey? Will you follow Jesus with no turning back? Do you have faith? If you do, deeds will follow, and you will keep on keeping on for Christ. To him be all the glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. He's calling us to do more. Are you called? You never know. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for being with us this morning. We thank you for what you do in our tiny church. Thank you for supporting us, because without you, we would all be nothing. We ask you to lead us and guide us, each one of us individually, to wherever you want us to go. Lead us on, because we're not finished yet. We have the faith. We're willing to do the deeds. Lord, we ask you to show us how. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's turn to our final song, and we'll do the first verse of number 664 in the hymnal, sent forth by God's blessing. Extinguish the two black candles first, and then the crushed candle, we light that, and we extinguish it here, and now we take it out to the world. That's what that all means. That's what we do here. So here's the benediction, folks. Beloved, may God bless you today and all days with wisdom that guides you to notice the needs of all around you and to share in the work of nurturing abundant life for all of God's creation. Amen. That's your job. Take it out there. You're not done yet. There's still more to do. God bless. Have a great day.